Hello my friends, on my table you see two amplifiers. The first one is the Advanced Acoustic MAA406, and this amplifier came out in 2006. And this amplifier, that is the Advanced XA160, this one came out in 2013, so a difference from 7 years. There are some differences, because I explained to you in my previous video that this one have some, or had some faults, some serious faults, and most of these faults were solved in their second or Mark II 406 amplifier. They did not change the name. Advanced Acoustic did not change the name, only they brought out a 406 with a switch on the back. The only difference was a switch in the back, so you can switch over to A class or A and B class, yeah. And that change was made soon after this first model came out, and my thoughts were, because you never know the in and outsides from a brand or a particular device, my thoughts was that they made this second or upgrade came to life to, well, to solve the problems, you know, to solve the problems. And they knew that the second amplifier was much better as the first one, and as you can see, the differences are there. This is the first one, and this is the latest model, 2013, yeah. And in between they had another one with the A and B class. So, but that amplifier, I don't have that amplifier. I only have these two amplifiers to see what is the difference. As you can see, both have this huge Stravo, and they look the same, but they are not the same. They are not the same. Let me see. No, they are not the same. This one looks bigger, but officially on paper they are both 700 VA volt ampere, so 700 volt ampere this one, and this one is 700 volt ampere. And well, not sure how good these Stravos are, but they are pretty strong looking. And the layout is the same. I love this layout. This is the same layout as you can see in, for example, Equiphases. An Equiphase amplifier always have or the Travo here or the Travo here, and the power caps over here, and or the other way around, but they are always in the middle with the left board here or the right board here and the left board on this side. Same construction, very easy to repair, because the only thing, if you need to repair a board like this, you just screw these big cooling plates loose. You can lose them from the underside of this amplifier very easy, and then this complete board you can turn, you know, so very easy to repair. And it looks like these two boards looks like each other, but this is not the same, my friends. It's not completely the same. There are some differences. They use other quality pots, as you can see over here. This one, for example, in the corner. Yes, let me zoom in for you. You can see what I mean. That one is a gold color, gold black color. And this one is a, on this side, the same one is a gray one, as you can see over here. Yeah, let me go a little bit out of the light so you can see it better what I mean. Yeah. And as you can see, that they are not exactly the same boards. It looks like they changed maybe. If I if I, well, I'm not sure, but there are some changes, and I cannot say it is 95% the same or 99% the same, but there are some small differences in these boards. Yes, also in these power boards, you see over here they have two over here. Yeah, let me show you what I mean. Over here you have two fuses. Yeah, between here you see the two fuses over here. Yeah, okay, you see them over there, the two fuses, and there are no fuses on this board, not at all. Probably they are on the side because it have to have fuses, but they are on the side, I think. Well, not I think, I'm sure they are on the side, and it's a little bit hard to remove or to get close by if you need to change a fuse, but they are there, but not on the upper top. So this board have some differences. Also this one, the new one, also have a A and B switch and a switch for the view meters, for the lights out, normal lighting or bright lighting, and that is this board. Yeah, this thick plate what you see over here is, well, it is shielding the VU meters from the back of the from the rest of the amplifier, and the same counts for this. But as you also see, that this one is completely closed, and this one have two holes. Not sure why the holes are for. Another difference is that these caps, let me zoom in for you, show you what I mean. These caps are KM, what was it? 63 volt, 15,000 microfarad each. So 63 volt, 15,000 microfarad each, and together they are 60,000 microfarad. And these are 80 volt, 10,000 microfarad. So only 40,000 volt, or 40,000 microfarad. And that's a huge difference. But for some reason, the technicians thought that this was a better thing for this amplifier than this one, because this thing had a few mistakes. And as you can see, over here you have these two small cooling plates. You also have them here, yeah, but the two pots over here, they are much bigger as the two pots over here. You know, they just give it another spot, but these two pots are the same pots as the pots over here, only they give them another space on this board. And for the rest, I can say they very much look like each other. Not much difference. There is some difference, of course. You can see that right away. But they did not just replaced this old board to the new one. And these old left board and right board to the new one. No. They made some changes, and probably they learned their lessons from the first mistakes they make in this amplifier, this first one, and they only changed the mistakes, the faults, and they improved that in this model. And it is always better to improve a old good model what have faults than to make a complete new designs, and because a new design can also have its own new problems. So that's what they did in Advanced Acoustic. They just use the old boards, improve them, and use them for their new amplifier. So this is what I wanted to show you. This is what I wanted to show you, that what I expected, that these two Well, these two amplifiers have much in common. Officially, this thing is 2 × 160 watts. Officially, but they calculated this by measurements, and you will see that link. I will place a link in the comment section, or in the subscription box. I will place a link where you can see a full review. You know, they tested this amplifier. And this same guy who tested this amplifier also tested this amplifier, and and you see the differences, what he thinks about the new amplifier in comparison with the old one. Well, this is what I wanted to show you. You know, the differences between these two amplifiers. You can see this is not a cheap built amplifier, my friends. I mean, it looks like, well, the old one looks okay, very nice, and they look exactly or almost exactly the same. And I like this style of making amplifiers. I like that, you know, the big cooling plates left and right, every channel have 4 transistors, yes, so 8 together. And this is it, my friends. This is what I wanted to show you. And you cannot see the transistors from here with this camera. Camera is not good enough to go inside completely. But this was the video. These two amplifiers, yes, next to each other. Thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up. And for now, I say ciao, ciao.